One of the main culprits of global warming is the vast amount of carbon dioxide pumped out into the atmosphere, mostly from burning fossil fuels and the production of steel and cement. In response, scientists have been trying out a process that can sequester waste carbon dioxide, transporting it into a storage site and then depositing it at a place where it cannot enter the atmosphere. The problem is that capturing carbon from power plants and industrial emissions isn't very cost-effective. The main reason is that waste carbon dioxide isn't emitted pure, but is mixed with nitrogen and other gases, and extracting it from industrial emissions requires extra energy consumption, meaning a pricier bill. Scientists have been trying to develop an energy-efficient carbon dioxide filter. Referred to as a membrane, this technology can extract carbon dioxide out of the gas mix, which can then be either stored or converted into useful chemicals. However, the performance of current carbon dioxide filters has been limited by the fundamental properties of currently available materials. Now, a team of chemical engineers from EPFL have developed the world's thinnest filter from graphene, the world-famous wonder material that won the Physics Nobel in the year 2010. But the graphene filter isn't just the thinnest in the world. It can also separate carbon dioxide from a mix of gases such as those coming out of industrial emissions and do so with an efficiency and speed that surpasses most current filters. The work is published in the journal Science Advances. The researchers say their approach was simple. They made carbon dioxide-sized holes in graphene, which allowed carbon dioxide to flow through while blocking other gases such as nitrogen, which are larger than carbon dioxide. The result is a record-high carbon dioxide capture performance. The researchers estimate that this technology will drop the cost of carbon capture close to $30 per ton of carbon dioxide, in contrast to commercial processes where the cost is 2 to 4 times higher. The team is now working on scaling up the process by developing a pilot plant demonstrator to capture 10 kilograms carbon dioxide per day in a project funded by the Swiss government and the Swiss industry.